Today, in battery technology, we will be studying the examples of secondary batteries, nickel cadmium and lithium ion batteries. These are the secondary batteries. They can be discharged and recharged for a number of times. The main features of the secondary cells are rechargeable batteries. Reactions can be readily reversed, similar to primary cells, except the redox reaction can be reversed. During recharging, electrodes undergo the opposite process than discharging. Cathode is oxidized and produces electrons, and these electrons are absorbed by anode. Nickel cadmium battery. In this, the anode is cadmium hydroxide and the cathode is nickel hydroxide. The electrolyte is potassium hydroxide. The main features of nickel cadmium battery are it gives or maintains a steady voltage of 1.2 volt per cell until completely discharged. It has ability to deliver full power output until end of the cycle. It have consistent power delivery throughout the entire application. Very low internal resistance it has and lower voltage per cell. They are used in electronic calculators, electronic flash unit, transistors. Nickel cadmium cells are widely used in medical instrumentation and in emergency lighting and toys. The main advantage of this battery is the chemistry of the battery is reliable. It operates in wide range of temperature and performs well after long period of storage. The main disadvantage is it is 3 to 5 times more expensive than lead acid. Its materials are toxic and the recycling infrastructure for larger nickel cadmium batteries is very limited. Another widely used secondary cell is lithium ion battery. This battery consists of lithium anode dissolved as iron into a carbon. The cathode material is made up of lithium liberating compound. Typically, the three electroactive oxide materials are used: lithium cobalt oxide, lithium manganese oxide, and lithium nickel oxide. During the charge and discharge process, lithium ions are inserted or extracted from interstitial space between atomic layers within the active materials of the battery. The lithium ion is transfers between anode and cathode through lithium electrolyte. Since neither the anode nor the cathode material essentially changes, the operation is safer than that of lithium metal battery. The main features of the lithium ion battery: the ideal material, that is lithium, which is light in weight, has low density, high reduction potential, largest energy density for weight. Lithium based cell are most compact ways of storing electrical energy, lower in energy density than lithium metal. So lithium ion is a safe battery. Energy density is twice of the standard nickel cadmium. No memory and no scheduled cycling is required to prolong battery life. This is a very important advantage. Mainly, the structure of lithium ion cell is four layered. It has a cathode, which is a positive electrode, made up of lithium cobalt oxide, has a current collector made up of thin aluminium foil, whereas anode, which is a negative electrode, made with specialty carbon, which has a current collector as thin copper foil, the separator, which is a fine porous polymer film, and the electrolyte, which is made up with the lithium salt in an organic solvent. The electrolytes are selected in such a way that they should be an effective transport of lithium ion to cathode during discharge. The type of conductivity of electrolyte is ionic in nature rather than electronic. This is the lithium ion battery, how the lithium ions move across the anode and cathode during charging and discharging. You can see very clearly. The main features are the lithium-ion battery, which is commonly and widely used, has graphite anode, lithium cobalt dioxide as cathode. Electrolyte is a mixture of lithium salt. Lithium-ion battery gives the discharge voltage 4 volt. The charging and discharging reactions are reversed during charging and discharging operation. During charging, lithium in positive electrode material is ionized and moves from layer to layer and inserted into a negative electrode. During discharge, lithium ions are dissociated from the anode and they migrate across the electrolyte and are inserted into a crystal structure of the host compound of cathode. At the same time, the compensating electrons travel in the external circuit and are accepted by the host to balance the reaction. The process is completely reversible, thus the lithium ion pass back and forth between the electrodes during charging and discharging. Advantages: they have high energy density than other rechargeable batteries. They are light in weight, produce high voltage output, around 4 volt as compared to other batteries, have improved safety, no liquid electrolyte, means there is no leakage problem, and fast charge and discharging rates. Only disadvantage is they are expensive and they are not available in standard cell type. They are used in cameras, calculators. They are used in cardiac pacemaker and other implantable devices. Used in telecommunication equipment, instruments, portable radios, TVs and pagers. They are used to operate laptop computers, mobile phones and aerospace applications. Based on this presentation in which we have discussed what are nickel cadmium batteries and what are the lithium ion batteries which work as a secondary cells, few questions you have to answer in your assignment book. Thank you.